The way I see it is that technology has immense power to change things, either for good or for bad. I don't think that technology itself is good or bad. And I think that I'm really excited about leveraging that immense power for what I think of as good. Around my junior year, I started to get really interested in gender issues. And I think that I had always been. But I particularly noticed that there was a really active women in CS group, Harvard Wix, for those of you who aren't familiar. And the same wasn't the case in math. And in fact, the ratios in math were even worse than the ratios in CS. So there were actually no tenured female professors in the Harvard math department. And
yeah, that's like pretty significant.
Yeah. So I was running the Undergraduate Math Association. And I realized that there was a real need to really just start having these tough conversations and start talking about start talking about the elephant in the room is what I called it, right? Like there were maybe two women out of like 30 concentrators in one year, and
Meena being the person who shakes things up steps in and is like, okay guys.
So I think that what was really fun about this group that I started, Gender Inclusivity in Math, is that it was actually born out of this idea of data or technology plus activism. So what we did was we actually surveyed all of the math undergraduates at Harvard, and we just, you know, gave a survey about like various aspects of student life in the math department. So we asked, do you feel comfortable in the common spaces? How many professors do you feel comfortable asking for a letter of recommendation? How comfortable do you feel at all?
Just like, getting like ideas of comfort levels. And then what?
And then we analyze it by gender. And that's where it got really interesting. Because we found some pretty big disparities on those answers by gender. And I think for any given individual, it's hard to separate, is this just me or is it because of my gender? And so what's really cool about using data plus combining that with gender or any minority group is that you can then start to have quantifiable data where previously it was more anecdotal. So especially because the people that we were trying to convince was the math department.
They care about numbers.
They really care about numbers. So we found that it actually just like exploded into this conversation. That, and so basically we held a panel to talk about the survey, and and like we were expecting, you know, we had our random room in like Seaver Hall at Harvard, and just like more than 100 people showed up.
No way. That's amazing.
Insane, including a lot of our professors. What I realized was that it wasn't that my classmates were apathetic. It's that they didn't know how to even talk about the issue.
Yeah. Like they cared, but there wasn't like a space to talk about it.
Exactly. And so I actually, I co-started GIIM along with Vikram Sundar, who was a male math major freshman at the time. And we really, along with Amanda Glazer, thought a lot about like how can we best actually make policy level change within the math department. So it was really cool to like have male allies be central from the beginning. And that wasn't really a choice for us because there were so few women. There weren't enough women to even have a student group, really. So what do you do when there aren't enough women to make a student group? Like you involve everyone in the community.
Yeah. And that's like interesting too, because I don't think I would have made that connection in my head between tech and social activism, but it's like clear that's very much what you do and like how you link those together.